I've had a testimony on my mind ever since last Tuesday night.
All right. Amen.
Last Tuesday night, when God done it, it shocked me so much I couldn't talk about it.
All right.
And Sunday, I wanted to, but I wanted to hold it for tonight for some reason.
Oh.
Amen. God is still answering prayer.
That's it.
God is still speaking if we'll listen.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Right. There are several different ways, Brother David, he speaks to us.
That's right.
Amen. Sometimes he speaks to me in the spirit.
Yeah.
And I know what he wants me to do. Sometimes it's through his word to a man of God or somebody that's up preaching his word.
Yeah.
Or maybe if I just open it and start reading, he starts speaking to me.
Come on.
But every now and then.
Come on.
Every once in a while, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
He's got that audible voice. And he speaks to me just like I'm reaching down here speaking to Brother Tyler.
Come on.
Amen. And when that comes, Brother Billy, it ain't happened to me. You know, I've heard a lot of people say it happens to them a lot of times, but it ain't happened to me a lot of times.
Come on.
Amen. And when it happens to me, sometimes it just blows my mind.
Yeah.
I come in Tuesday night, and we had a great service. Brother Mike preached, and it was a great service. But I was sitting right back here where my wife sitting right there on the back row.
Yeah.
And God spoke to my spirit. Start with, Brother Bill.
Come on.
See it.
Y'all might not even believe it. It's going to blow your mind now.
Come on.
He spoke to my spirit. He told me, he said, give Sister Myrtle
$20.
Yeah. And Brother Bill, I opened my billfold. I had $8 in it.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, I ain't got no $20. So I got that $8 out. And I'm going to give it to $8. Then all of a sudden, he spoke in my ear. Brother Rodney was standing back there by the door, and I thought it was him saying something.
Yeah.
And he gave me a scripture to go to.
Come on.
He told me to go to Luke, the 6th chapter and the 38th verse. Oh. Right in my ear, Brother Bill.
Yeah.
Just like if you were speaking it to me.
Come on.
And I went over. And this is what I seen. I seen his word, and it wasn't marked, and I didn't have a marker there, and I was shaking like a leaf trying to find it.
Yeah.
Because I know it was God speaking to me, amen?
Yeah.
And his word said, give and it shall be given unto you.
Yeah,
come on.
Good measure, pressed down and shaken together.
Yeah.
And running over.
Yeah.
And shall men give into your bosom.
Amen.
For with the same measure that you meant, withal it shall be measured unto you again.
Yeah.
And I read that scripture, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden I looked down.
Uh-huh.
And there was a $20 bill folded in my Bible.
My goodness.
And I took it real quick and I handed it back to Sister Myrtle.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want the devil to say, well, you ain't got but $8, keep that $20.
Yeah. Come on.
Amen. He'll do that kind of stuff to you.
Yeah. Amen.
And it shocked me so much I couldn't even talk about it, Brother Bill.
Yeah.
Because I've never had nothing like that happen to me. Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's God. Amen. That's the way God is doing. When God tells you to do something, he'll make a way, Brother David.
Oh.
When you don't seem like you got no way.
Oh.
There was no way that
Hallelujah.
I could do it. Amen. I didn't have it. All I have is $8.
Come on.
But I know what he spoke to my spirit. And I know what he talked to me in his voice. Amen.
Come on.
And I didn't see it when I opened it to him.
Yeah.
When I read the scripture.
Come on.
It may have been there.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was or not, to be honest with you. But I kind of believe it wasn't.
Yeah.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And my wife said, well, how did it get in there?
Uh-huh.
I said, I don't know. I even thought about it, brother. Maybe I stuck it in there some years back.
Come on.
And it had been over there part of the Bible or something.
Right.
Honey, some of them look at the Bibles on the desk, they ain't looked in for 100 years. They don't tell them what you'll find in there. Oh, hallelujah.
Oh.
If you get in that word, you can find something in there you need. Amen. God may speak to you tonight and want you to find something that you need. All you got to do is get out in that word. It's in there. Amen. Whatever you need is in his word. Amen.
Yeah.
That's right.
And I got to thinking, and I told her, I said, well, maybe somebody at church somewhere stuck it in there.
Yeah.
But I got to think about it, Brother Billy. It don't matter. If God put it in there, or Brother Billy put it in there, Brother Tyler put it in there, it's still God. Amen.
Amen.
It's still God. He's the one to make a way. He's the one that showed me where to look even.
Come on.
And tonight as I was walking around here and we was praying, I seen this little article up there tonight, Brother Billy, and I've seen them thousand times together, but I got some in my briefcase.
Yes.
About the King James Version Bible.
Oh.
Where all the other versions take part of it out. And I got to thinking, if I'd had one of them other versions,
right.
I might not grab the $5 because somebody might not took 15 worth of it. Oh! We got to have it all. Everything we need is in here. Amen. Everything I need is in here.
Come on.
Too many people trying to build their life on everything else. Honey, we got to build it upon the rock. Come this on. Is the only thing going to stand. Heaven and earth shall pass away. Amen. But my word will stand. Amen.
Amen.
We got to build it upon it. Amen. Because everything else is going to pass away. Just like it did over in Matthew, the 7th chapter. And they talk about the man build his house upon the rock.
Yeah. Come on.
Because he was a doer of God's word.
Yeah.
And the one that wasn't a doer built upon the sand when the storms came and the winds blowed. The one that wasn't built upon God couldn't stand. Honey, we ain't going to stand today if we don't build upon this rock. Man.
That's right.
Come on.
Say it.
But what I really got out of it more than anything.
All right.
Whatever I've got need of, Brother Bill.
Come on.
It don't matter what it is.
Yeah.
All I got to do is look in the book. The answer's in the book. It might not be the $20, buddy, but the answer's in the book. Whatever your problem is, whatever trial you're going through, whatever hardship you're going through, honey, your answer is in the book.
Hallelujah.
It's in here. Everything I need, Brother Billy, is in here.
Amen.
Everything that God wants me to have is in here.
Come on.
I want a little junk that God don't want me to have.
Come on.
Right.
But everything in here, he wants me to have.
That's right.
Everything in here is mine if I just receive it.
Come on.
Because he's given it to me.
Come on.
Amen. But we got to stand upon his word.
Absolutely.
Everything else is going to pass by. That ain't got nothing to do with my sermon. I'll get ready to preach here in a minute.
Amen.
Amen.
That's
all
right. That's good.
But it just blows my mind when God does things like that.
Come on. Amen.
He don't speak to me all the time like that, Sister Richard. I mean, I hear him a lot in the spirit, and I can get down and pray and talk to him, but he don't speak that audible voice.
Come on.
Like that. And it just, when he done it, I didn't even tell my wife about it.
Come on.
Matter of fact, her mama told her about it. Amen.
Right.
But that's the way it works. That's the way God does.
That's
Amen. It just blows your mind.
That's
and that's why I was praying today and asking God what he want me to preach.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, I seen one of them little bands people used to wear. What would Jesus do?
Yeah.
And I asked myself this question, what would Jesus preach?
All right.
Uh-oh.
Come on.
Amen.
What would he preach to his church
Come on.
Today?
Yeah.
Amen.
Would it all be a love message?
Come on.
He preached a lot on love.
Yeah.
Would maybe a healing service. He done a lot of healing. But I believe with all my heart, he'd preach on sin.
Come on.
Honey, their sin is going wild all through the country today. Amen.
That's
they just legalized same-sex marriages in New York City and they're killing babies by the thousand. Honey, because if they legalize it, still don't make it not sin.
Amen.
Amen. They can legalize everything. And Obama can pass every law he wants to and say it's all right. But honey, God says it's sin and it's still sin.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
See, everybody wants to believe when Jesus said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forever when it comes to your healings.
Yeah.
Or when it comes to your deliverance.
Yeah.
But they want to change it. If he's the same yesterday, today, forever, he's still the same on sin.
Come on.
He hasn't changed his mind, Brother David. There's a lot of people that have changed their mind. Amen. This world is in bad shape.
Come on.
It's on its way to hell in a hand-basket fast. Amen.
Come on.
The church is going to, and that's the sad part, the church is headed right behind them.
Come on. Yeah.
That's true.
Amen. They're ordained homosexuals being in the pulpit and preaching the word.
Come on.
That ain't God.
No, it ain't.
Amen. That ain't God.
No.
It's time the church is going to have to get some backbone.
Come on.
The preacher's going to have to get some backbone.
Come on.
And start crying loud.
Yeah.
Like it says in Isaiah 58:1, cry loud. Spare not.
Come on.
It's time that somebody start preaching the truth. Somebody tell them that they're going to have to live a separated life.
Come on.
You can't live. There's preachers that say you can live together, not married, and make it to heaven.
Yeah.
Come on, pay me your tithes, sit on my pew.
That's it.
It's all right if man and woman live together, a woman and woman live together, man and man live together. Just sit on the pew and pay my tithes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on.
Leading them straight to hell.
Come on.
Somebody's going to have to preach against it. Somebody's going to have to make a stand.
That's it.
And I believe with all my heart the preachers that's telling them it's all right and they can do all this, they're not God called.
Come on.
See it.
They may be called some kind of spirit, but they're not God called. Because when God calls them, he tells them to preach it, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
And it don't say anything in there about that's all right.
No.
It don't say in my Bible that it's all right for you to sin. And as long as you come to church, as long as you pay your tithes to a certain church, you can go ahead and sin, you can still make it heaven. It don't say it in here.
All right.
Amen.
Come on.
And that's what he told us to preach.
Amen.
His word. Amen. His words aren't things going to last, church. His words is what we got to build our foundation upon. That's what we got to build our life upon. We got to go by this.
Amen.
This is what's going to get us through. Nothing else, Brother David.
That's
amen.
It.
Brother Billy can't get me there, but this will.
Amen.
This will. If I hang on to his word, amen, and I trust his word, it'll get me home. Amen. It's already been blood bought and paid for.
Yes, come on, sir.
Amen.
That's the truth.
This is Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Amen. If we'll trust him, we'll make it.
Amen.
As long as we build our house upon that rock, we'll make
all right.
it.
Right.
Come on.
But we ain't got there yet.
Amen.
We ain't made it yet, Sister Reason.
That's right.
He said to he that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved.
Yeah.
Amen.
We still got some enduring to do.
That's right.
We still got some presence. Yes, sin's rising, but God's moving.
Come on, amen.
God's moving. God's doing something for his people. Amen.
Amen.
It may seem like that, what he done for me, $20, that may seem like a little thing, but it's a great big thing to me.
Amen.
And it let me realize, it let me know that he will answer. If he tells me to do something, he will make the way. Amen. If I just listen, if I obey and do what he wants me to do, he'll make a way.
That's right.
You may say, well, maybe Sister Myrtle didn't need it. It don't matter if she needed it or not. I'm just asking $2,000. If God told me to give it, I'm going to give it. Amen.
Come on.
I need it. If nobody else needed it, I needed the blessing. Amen. I want the blessing. I mean, what his word says, every promise in here, I want it, Brother David. Amen. If he promises to me, I want it. Amen. And it's ours when we can receive it. But you can't receive it running around in sin. You can't receive it doing everything in the world. The only way you're going to receive it is get a closer walk with him. Spend some time on your knees. Spend some time in his word. Spend some time where he wants you at. Honey, we got to get back to the old fashioned path.
Amen.
It's time the church wake up.
Come on.
Honey, Jesus is getting ready to come back.
Amen.
And he's coming back after people have made themselves ready. And honey, I'm afraid a lot of us ain't ready.
Come on.
Amen.
I want to be ready, Brother David. I don't want to miss it. I want to make it. Whatever it takes, Lord, keep me humble. Billy Sainton Long, whatever it takes, Lord, get my way. Amen.
Come on.
If I'm going astray, Lord, you get my way. And you turn me back to where you want me to be.
Come on.
Back to the cross.
Yeah.
Back to the old fashioned preaching, amen. Back to the word, amen. The word's what's going to get us through. My opinions won't get you there. Brother Billy's opinions won't get you there.
Come
but
on.
God's opinions.
Amen.
It'll get you there, amen.
Hallelujah.
And I know sometimes it's a tight walk. I know that sometimes walking for God, it ain't always a bed of roses.
All right.
We're going to have battles. We're going to have trials. But like that song says, it's going to be worth it all.
Amen.
One of these days, Brother David, when we cross over into glory, honey, it's going to be a bed of roses there. Amen. It's going to be wonderful. It's going to be a place that we won't have to worry about getting sick again.
That's right.
You know what's going to be there? His word.
Amen.
His word will be there.
That's it.
His word will be there.
Amen.
And we got to become a doer. Just get up and go.
All right.
Like Brother Tyler was saying, it's time. We know the word.
Yeah.
We know what we're supposed to be doing.
Yeah.
There's not a one in us in here that don't know right and wrong.
That's it.
We know.
Come on.
And the Bible says he that knows to do good and do it not to him, it's a sin.
That's it.
So we know, Brother David. We're without excuse.
That's right.
We know.
Amen.
It's time I start being a doer.
That's the truth.
It's time I start walking this thing. It's time, let's take the word and apply it to our life.
Yes,
our daily walk, Sister Richard, not just in the church. A lot of people can walk it inside the church building.
Right.
But what about in Walmart? Can you walk it in Walmart?
Whoa.
Can you walk it when you're out to a ball game somewhere? Can you walk it when you run into a sick person in the hospital or whatever? It's time that we learn to walk it.
See,
everywhere.
Yeah.
We got to apply it to the, we got to become His word.
Come on.
Jesus was the flesh. I mean, Jesus was the word made flesh. We're the flesh and we need to be made word.
That's it.
Amen.
If we can get in this word and get it.